Today we go inside the herd with the Bucknell Bison's track and field team. Today Bison fans gathered at Christy Mathewson Stadium to witness the first annual Bison Last Chance Heptathlon. Expectations were high and the competition was fierce as these postseason track studs took a shot at the record books in the women's multi. Kevin McGuire had a very strong start, winning the 100-meter low hurdles and tying the school record in the high jump with a leap of 5 feet 7 inches. Kirsten Rudd, Steve Lewandowski, Brian Charlin, Justin O'Brien, and Ian Shore were close behind in a competitive battle for the silver medal. During the third event of the multi, the shot put, the athletes showed some serious swagger, but the results were absolutely pathetic. After four events, we were able to speak with some of the athletes. Many were a tad bit disappointed in their personal performances.
How do you feel going into the long jump?
I'll tell you what, I mean, my training hasn't been going well, and it's showing today. I'm not hitting my marks like I want to. It looks like the top 10 list might be out of the question, but I'm going to keep going. I'm just going to go out and give it my best. My 800 probably isn't going to be fast enough here with all the wear on my legs, so.
Nice. Well, we wish you the best of luck finishing
Thanks.
Up your first women's heptathlon.
As long as my outfit's the best, that's what matters.
It's all that matters. Thank you.
Thanks.
So, Steve, after being way, way behind pace in the first four events, how do you feel going into the long jump?
Well, right now I'm just looking at third place. I think Lunchbox is coming back to me now that we're getting to more explosive competitions. Throwing the jab back in freshman year of high school, so. It's looking pretty good for me, so.
Nice. Thank you, Steve, and good luck with the rest. So, Brian, after the first four events, you're sitting right about middle of the pack. How do you feel going into the long jump?
You know, obviously Kevin's a triple jumper, and he has some experience in this event, but I mean, I really think I can give him a little bit of trouble. Maybe, we'll see. I don't know. I think it's really gonna come down to me picking up ground in the 800.
Absolutely.
I've never thrown a javelin before, and I used to do the 800 in high school, so we'll see what happens.
Nice. Well, I wish you the best of luck finishing your first women's heptathlon.
Thank you.
Despite the struggles of his competition, Kevin McGuire seemed to be performing quite well and was confident that the long jump would be much of the same.
Yeah, that's right. Not satisfied. Still got the long jump coming up. Favorite event. About to fly. It's going to be great.
Thanks, Kevin, and good luck on your quest to the women's heptathlon outdoor record.
Thank you, appreciate it.
The sixth event, the javelin throw, changed the outlook of the competition. Kevin took third place, losing his first event to Steve Lewandowski and Justin O'Brien. Justin won the event with a throw of 29.95 meters, and he was ecstatic.
He's going to remember that fourth place finish, and that's going to be in his head when I'm passing him in the 800. That's my best event here. So I'm still looking the best. I still got the best outfit. And I think with a good run and McGuire maybe slipping once or twice, I can run the points down here.
All right, thank you.
To get on that women's top 10 list.
Thank you.
The athletes were moving through the events at a grueling pace, completing the first six in only an hour and a half. Many of the competitors needed to drop out.
So, Steve, Rudd and Shore have officially dropped out of the multi-event. This gives you an automatic lock for fourth place.
Yeah.
Does that give you confidence going into the 800?
Well, I'm thinking about going out in a 55, 56 for my first four. Coming in, trying to beat Kevin by a good 30 seconds for the W. But who knows?
Yeah, that's aggressive. I like it.
Yeah. Got to go for the win.
Absolutely. I'll see you out there.
Yeah. Thanks.
So, Kevin, you just lost your first event to Justin O'Brien. He took it in the javelin. Does this ruin your momentum going into the 800?
Definitely not. Been looking forward to this event for the last year and a half. I've been training. I have Eric, the speedster, bow band spikes. Put some extra special stuff on the bottom. I'm ready to go. I'm hitting 215 today.
All right, sounds good.
And with that, the last event was off. The 800 meter run. The race came down to the wire, but Brian Charlin won his first event, registering a time of 2:09.47. Kevin was close behind with a 2:13.61, followed by Steve's 2:14.09. And so the first annual Bison Last Chance Heptathlon proved to be a fun and successful meet. Steve Lewandowski finished fourth place overall with a total of 3,714 points. Justin O'Brien took the bronze medal and squeezed his way onto the top 10 list with a score of 3,837 points. Brian Charlin captured the silver and scored 6th on the all-time list with 4,240 points. Our champion, Kevin McGuire, shattered the school record with a score of 5,691 points while also breaking school records in the high jump, long jump, and 200-meter dash. We thank all of our Bison fans, as well as our meet officials for making the meet run smoothly. Let's make this a tradition for future years, and now stick around for some extra photos.
I paid my dues, time after time. I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my shells and kicked in my bed, but I've come through.
And I need to go on, 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 on.
We are the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end. We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions of the world. I've taken my bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all. But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it.